Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we will be diving into an application called Supernotes. This is a web application that has been getting a lot of attention, especially with students and those who are taking light notes. Now, as you can imagine, lots of note-taking applications, a lot of attention around Rome. I will be diving into Rome in much more detail as I slowly return. But as you can imagine, this application is getting a lot of hype at the moment, especially on Product Hunt. So a little bit of the facts before we begin. This application is currently free. They have a promotional sort of setup where you get 2 months free unlimited notes as you get started. But then I believe it's sort of like MailerNote and other applications where you get gifted cards when you get started. So I will be diving through the concept of this application and explaining it here on the video. So without further ado, folks, let's dive into today's video. So here we are inside of Supernotes. Now, I was playing around with this last night, just giving it a bit of a sort of toy around with the style of the application, obviously getting used to how it looks like. And as you can see here, on this left-hand side, we've got the sidebar, and it works very similar to a note-taking application, but sort of like an outliner at the same time. So on this left-hand side, you get to create these sort of parent topics or parent cards. And as you can see here, I've got one for a masterclass here. And as you can see, it comes up in this note board in the center. So on this sidebar, you can actually see the like parent note, and in the center, you can open up what's inside that note. So you can do it by opening up this thing called Noteboard. When you open up the Noteboard, all of the relevant notes appear. So before we go into how that works, you can just use Home View. Home View allows you to see a stream of any of the notes that you have created, which is quite a nice little layout. The only thing I'd say is that it would be nice to sort of have it as a sort of grid layout, a bit more sort of open, but very similar to like some applications like Google Keep. As a sort of layout. So you can close down this sidebar, and also on this sidebar you can access filters. We'll touch on that in a bit. And also up here you can sort your cards alphabetically, date created and last edited, as well as another view called seamless views. So you can just see a stream without any of the hearts and all of the, you know, detail on comments and things like that. You can also print as PDF and export as markdown. Now, one of the things that you can do down here as well is this is where you add stuff to your account. You can go ahead and create a card. We'll create a card and show you the little details inside of the card, but you can also join the cards. And this is the reason why it's very popular with students and those who are looking to almost flash card some of their learnings and notes as they go. So once you can add or join a Supernotes using a code, a share code, and once you enter it, you'll have access into that. And naturally, it's sort of like a team access to some extent, because you can heart stuff, comment, and actually respond to stuff or forward it too. So it's sort of not like copying into your area, but it is at the same time, because you can be able to view it on that left-hand side panel. So let's go ahead and create a brand new card. And as you can see, when I press new card, this sort of like panel pops up, and it's in the home area because I'm not actually selecting a certain parent that we've already created. So if I wanted to, for example, write down some week three lessons, and I'd started doing that last night, like week three, and then adding them to this parent that we've created. So if you go up here, you can press plus, and this opens up a range of options. You can keep your notes organized using tags. So for example, if I clicked in and I clicked it as lessons, and you can make them personal if you want to, or public. So, you know, you can take that one off and just have that as a personal one. And you can see that the hashtag comes up in this bottom right-hand corner. You can also give it a parent. And as you can see, any new card you create could be a parent. So for example, if I wanted to search new dad, because maybe these are all the lessons that I've learned in the first month, I can have that there. Now you can give it an icon as well. So if you wanted to give it a little bit more of a sort of bit more detail, you can search for a specific icon. So if I typed in baby carriage, there we go. Just adds a little bit of addition to it. And you can see here that I've actually given one of the parents icons here, and I've added an emoji at the front. So you can customize this quite a lot. You can also add a link, image, or emoji to this, which may help, you know, to add, for example, add an inline link to another card, so you can connect cards up. So for example, if I wanted to connect this card up before, so I could say lessons from week two, lessons to review, and that can be connected up to the previous card, and show you how that works in a moment. A little bit like Rome, which is quite cool. You can also add an image, and we've done that down here with this image here, and you can see that it appears beautifully in line. That's a little Otto. And you can also add a color, which does help it sort of stand out. You can see I've added ones to actual parent cards. So you can see that's a green one and a blue one down here. So that's the sort of additions you can add to it. They're different elements, and I can see them adding actually more of these as time goes on. So I just accidentally removed that, but if I were to go there, see, there we go. So what I can do here is actually start adding all the details I would to a note, and I've just been using the bullet points, and that's simply just by using those hyphens, but you can actually access something called the cheat sheet. So if I go down here, I can find the cheat sheet, and the cheat sheet will show you all the details, and it's pretty much marked down to some extent, but you can actually add things like bold, checklists, code, latex maths, but spoilers as well, which is quite cool, and highlights and more details like that. So if you learn that, you can naturally do that. The only one I've learned at the moment is the list view, which is quite good. But you can actually add a checklist item if you want to, which is very helpful. But there is a slash command that you can actually do during this and quickly access the options if you did want to. So I could say we could give him the dummy. Maybe, I don't know. And you can, once you press finish, down in the bottom right hand corner, you can actually press command enter, and that makes itself a note. So you can see here that I've been able to link to another note. So if I were to click into that, that then opens up on the preview screen. So that's quite handy to be able to link notes, not in the same way Rome works, but in some familiar way. But I can also click into the hashtag for any lessons that have been created, and that obviously sets off a filter. But in this case, I'm actually going to remove this filter and go back to what I had before. There we go. So I found the lesson. And if I click back in, you can see there, then I can do a few additional things. I can choose whether I want to index it or not. So that means appearing inside of the index on the left-hand panel, the sidebar, or I can junk it. It will also give you the last edited date and created on the time. So that's quite helpful for being able to sort of managing. So that's some of the editing. And if I wanted to actually open this up as a noteboard, I could actually add specific cards inside of week three. So for example, if I wanted to add additional lessons into that experience, I can. So going over to a new area we created, this masterclass one, I can go ahead and like it. And this is more useful for the study notes. If you were to join an area, I can add comments on it, and I can even produce its own share code. So if I wanted to copy that one to the clipboard, then I could do, and that's fairly easy too. I can also see who the new members are that are appearing here. You have to have an account to be able to join an area, and I can even modify the relationship I have with the note. So for example, am I a moderator? Am I an editor? Am I a contributor? Am I a reader, or am I a ghost? So it's pretty much, you know, full access to read access and lots more. So that's pretty helpful. So up here, I still get all of the abilities. For example, in my note card, I can see the seamless view. I can remove any, you know, be able to add and sort, you know, alphabetically just by moving them around if I had a few more notes. And you can see that I can set it to any new cards that are published or any new cards that are unlisted. And at any time I can refresh this so that I can see anything at a glance. So let's touch on some of the filtering abilities. So for example, if you had lots of different notes, you could filter which ones are yours, your ones you've created, which ones have been liked, kept, and you can actually set them on or off here, which is very helpful. And these are very useful for being able to create your own filters, but you can actually like add your own filters. So if you wanted to set up what authors set up with it, what tags, what colors, which might be useful, then you can have that. And that takes it a little bit further than the likes of Google Keep. So for example, if I wanted to only store see blue cards inside of the entirety of the home, I wanted to only see blue cards, then that's how you can get a filter set up. And all I have to do is click off that and all the regular cards will appear. So it's quite handy in being able to create and disable cards pretty instantaneously. Now, one thing I can do up here is search. So if I was looking for a specific thing about a lesson, I can quickly find it. So a bit about respect and your team members, which is fairly standard, doesn't have any super advanced settings up here too. But you can see here that I can also drop down items if I wish to see a bit of detail. As you can imagine, takes a bit of time to get used to, if I'm honest. I found that opening up these child cards got a little bit confusing. For example, like if I wanted to return to the child cards or I wanted to open a note board for a specific thing, sometimes felt a little bit complicated, but take a bit of time to get used to, and naturally it's quite easy once you've got it all set up. So up in the top right hand corner, you can refer a friend. You can also see how many cards you've used to date. I've used 7 out of the unlimited cards that are available. I can refer a friend. I can enter a coupon code, which probably be helpful in the future as they come out of beta. I can access my account settings, in which you can add a photo and change some of your password details. And there is a range of options. I know last night I was using the dark mode because it was very early, and I was accessing the application. Worked fairly well. That's good that you have dark mode from day one. You've got 2 other modes. I think one is like a brightness mode, one more contrasty. Can't really tell the difference in this light, but very helpful at a glance. So if I go down here, I can also go and access chat with us. It's currently in the 1.25 version, so that's still early days. You can take a tour, which was very helpful. You can access a cheat sheet, community forum, and add them on things like Twitter. But as you can imagine, this application's very early days. I quite like it. I think it's a nice addition to the note-taking space. It's almost like a nice blend between concepts of Rome, to some extent. I'm not, pointing a finger at it. I think it still has plenty of time to evolve, and the likes of Google Keep. If those two had a baby, it'd probably be Super Notes. I'm going to keep an eye on it. If the development continues, they may add this sort of more network thought experience that Rome has, and maybe some more clarity on the note boards that they have here. But fairly impressed, and I will be playing around with it a bit more. It could be a nice, real casual note taker for a lot of people. I'm going to reach out to the team, see what their developments are, because I'm interested for myself. But at the moment, this is something that you can try, and I think get 2 months free. So folks, I really hope you enjoyed this feature. Please do subscribe if you're brand new, and share your comments below and what you think about Super Notes. Okay, folks, cheerio.